Thank you. going to be in a bad spot. His balloon will also be able to get a reveal up there.
We could have got another 4 kills from this, and this would have been a fucking, like, 37.
Ooh. Another 4 kills and be 37, so what, are they on 33? Or is that what's possible if there's a squad of 3 remaining? But at this point, you start to wonder if it's just like that one guy that's hiding.
Yeah.
People right around us.
I have to see.
If I remember correctly, Team Moxie was on our leaderboard at least once. Mm. They had at least one of our top 20 frag games. Great shot, I've found him.
That's out.
Oh, they only respawn one.
There we go. Oh, he's going for the fist. Execute.
Let's go.
Wow.
I don't know if we've ever seen someone actually go for an execution.
Not intentionally. We saw one accidental.
Yeah.
Remember, there was a door jam, and then he accidentally started executing because of the door he was trying to open.
But he got the 20. Burton racking it up. How many kills did they get overall? Sound like they were saying like it was over 30.
Yeah, it's going to be like 36, I think.
Tomorrow season 2.
Given what they said, maybe I'm wrong. 32, all right.
32.
20 kills. It's actually quite hilarious that Urban had almost basically the same damage, but it was cheated out of 13 kills. But that is not bad. 32, that'll definitely land them on the leaderboard. I don't know how many points exactly that's good for. 30?
I think it puts them at least into the top 10, so I would say in the 30 range, yeah. And the best part is you're knocking everybody down a peg.
Yeah.
Everyone, like, all the kills, they were like, oh, I can guarantee I'm getting as many points. You probably just lost 10 points because of that game.
Yeah, it's going to be really interesting.
Yeah, the back end, the leaderboard knockout actually makes this a lot weirder than it normally would be.
Mm-hmm.
To where, like, I have a feeling it's gonna be pretty surprising at the end on how the points get distributed based on that.
Yeah.
People close to me, they lay down.
Yeah, I need like 50s. I need like 50 bullets or something heavy.
I can drop.
Oh yeah, 21 heavy.
For a Spitfire, that's is not a good look.
Nice. That's rough. It's real rough.
Yeah, I have no clue.
It's all good. Imperial is just taking them all down. That Peacekeeper. Well, I say all, it's just one so far.
One of them.
I'm sure more will follow.
Mirage is one shot, but he ulted.
Ah.
Wait, are you going for the Wraith?
And the ammo's gone.
Wraith is one.
Does it have the Havoc, though?
Does that have ammo? Because I feel...
Oh, there's some.
Is that armor? Yeah, I took it.
Get heals. I need heals.
Longbow there, too, if you'd like to swap over. Ops into the 99, gets the attachments.
We need to go there.
Yeah, let's go.
I'm taking the fucking balloon.
You must not have much Havoc ammo, either.
Do you guys have extra cells? I have one.
I feel like in that situation, if you have almost no, well, he still had, he had some energy ammo in his inventory. I feel like he's just like that. That's how much he doesn't want the Havoc. He's willing to take almost no bullets and a Spitfire and an R99.
Yeah.
Over a fully loaded Havoc.
And one just down. One's going. Wait.
Discover at least one.
I'm gonna.
One sitting on top of this massive structure here.
Go get him.
Flying off into the side. He lands in front of him. Bold move. Allowing some kind of response. Octane stimmed up. Just gonna run. Wow, that Wingcat underscore 7 didn't have much desire to play Apex Legends here this evening.
Yeah, that was actually pretty hilarious. I love the way that like the Octane runs. It looks like, it reminds me of like an anime character or something like that.
It's
like just extremely exaggerated.
I feel like we've got two anime runs in the game, right? That of like the Naruto of Wraith, right? With the arms back.
Oh, yeah.
And that's like the cool guy version of the spectrum. And then we've got like the derp idiot of the group, which is, our Octane running out there. It reminds me of like for some reason, like Ed, Edd and Eddy would run like that.
Yeah,
for some
probably.
Reason, like one of them.
All right, so here is our arcade leaderboard right now. And one thing I really want to point out here, Zoms was our leader at 35 kills. Moxie matched it at 35 kills. But then Zoms was able to beat their own record up to 39.
Wow.
Which means that they now have just 70 points in the top 2 games there. And I'm looking at scanning the rest of this. I do not see them.
Don't mind my head.
Oh, you
sorry.
Don't see anything at that point. I don't see them anywhere else on this board. So I think that their only 2 games they've made in the top 20 are the 2 that matter the most. But Visions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 games they have on this leaderboard right now. They are still the team that is gaining the most from this high kill leaderboard.
But they are the team that also has one of those results right at the bottom. So they're likely to be pushed out before the day is done.
Yes.
At least with that result. So they're going to need to post some more. Oh my days. That is...
I'm just running.
Oh god, the damage just... outrageous, isn't it?
Yeah, sometimes Huskers has moments where his aim is just, it feels like unparalleled. And that was a moment of it, even swapping over the Spitfire from the hip, didn't miss a single one on his way out.
There's a solo.
They do manage to be able to get the retreat and buy a little bit of time of shielding up, though. End up going with double cells, means that there's no batteries, which means we're only going to reside at the 50% shielding.
We need to this.
Oh, you know who he is, bro? He's the fucking. He's going to probably respawn south, I think.
Oh, let's hope he does.
He's the kid that we killed his wraith friend in the fucking house, and then the octane, right? The octane went down, right?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, he did. Yeah. I'm pretty sure that's that team.
Well, there's only one beacon left in zone, so...
Yeah. Let's just hope they don't run into each other and they have the beacon.
Well, let's hope Wraith fucking reses north.
I doubt it.
Yeah.
It's possible, I guess.
He's hidden, trying to work out exactly what's going on, trying to get that information working in their favor. And there's only two squads remaining. Got 12 kills on Huskers, so feels like it's probably a strong game. Of course, we can't see what dropped in Imperial have just yet, but that Leviathan man, tomorrow, he's going to be walking around.
Yeah, stomping on things.
Exciting times.
Endearingly named them Phil and Lil, and I'm excited to have them play.
make sure you have an eye on them.
But they're little baby Leviathans, I think.
All right. Well, you can see on the bottom here, we've got to vote for the Twitch Prime Apex Legends MVP using the Twitch Picks extension. It is time now, chat, for you to vote on that extension to see who is.
Do I get to vote?
Our MVP. I don't see any reason why not.
I already know who my vote's going.
Just pull out your phone, go to the Twitch Rivals, and go to the extension. You can vote for that one. It's like you get one vote. I don't see why not. It's not caster. But you don't have any way to influence it anyways, so. That's true. But go for it. I want to know who you guys pick. We've seen some pretty crazy plays.
Oh,
Ray is just trying to hide, literally, just trying to make the game as long as possible. Finished off, and that's a champion banner.
What a disgusting little spot to hide. That's in that little corner, blending in. Yeah, it's it reminds me, you know, it's like actually Albrelele, he has this like extremely vibrant skin. And I'm always like, in games like this, I'm gonna try to pick the skin which is least visible.
I'm always the same. And it's always amazing because it feels like, you know, really great players, they have the confidence of like, it's probably not gonna matter enough that they walk around with the most bright and bold of stuff, but I'm in the same boat. Yeah. I pick all of my skins based off of like, this will probably blend in the most generically with your average background.
Yeah, absolutely.
On board with Kefri, who we don't think we've seen yet today, but always a top fragger here.
Yeah.
Oh, he's got the Kraber again. I'm super excited, please.
Playing Mirage, which is absolutely ridiculous because Mirage is, I mean,
I think he's shooting.
He's using a flatline, a Kraber, and Mirage. This is
he's actually he's anti-meta. He is the anti-meta. Holy cow!
What is he thinking?
But he's even got ultimate accelerators too, for that matter, in his inventory.
Just don't miss forehead.
Kefri's prepared for tomorrow.
That's right.
I don't know.
He's living in Apex of the future right now.
I'm gonna say he's known a cheater.
Well, he's got 3 kills so far. I don't know if it's working. We'll have to see.
He's just only good at getting 20 kills. That's him.
That's him. Yeah.
All right, here we go. Line it up. Oh, he missed his opportunity. Hesitated.
Patience.
This is a great moment to get a Mirage ult, though, if you'd like a major flank and reposition on this target.
He stood still when he shot. That's the good news. So if someone
I like that.
I'm looking at him. Wait, he's walking into the wall.
There's a teammate behind him. No,
what is going on?
He's about to fire.
Are they trying to like just count the respawns or what exactly is going on? I mean, I'm not sure.
Yeah,
he's in the door frame.
He's gonna fire until he sees the whites of their eyes. Jeez.
Yeah, they're in that room. They're in that room. Yep.
Open the door.
Make the day.
Hey!
Thank you. New studies avail and prolific.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Cool.